Let's get it. How y'all doing, man? How is y'all doing? Look, y'all, I am back with another video. It is your boy Ty. I hope we all doing good. I hope we're all staying strong. I hope we're all finding a purpose. I hope we are all finding a creative outlet, something to get our creative energy out there, something that our creative energy is going to show. It's going to leave an imprint on people, inspire people to want to do better. Now, guys, today's video, I want to explain the loss of creativity in men. Now, guys, I just been thinking to myself lately, man. You know, I've been working out. When I'm chilling by myself, I tend to think a lot. I don't watch TV no more. I don't even use my TV. I don't even use my Xbox because I like to think. I like to be in my thoughts. And one thing I realized, when you look at things, when you look at the materials, the products that was being made by men from the 1920s, the 30s, the 40s, the 60s, when you look at the substance that they was putting in the materials back then, guys, it is nothing compared to what it is today, guys. Back then, they put all kind of creative energy into everything they made. They put substance into the things they made. They poured their soul into the things they made. These days, guys, young men are not doing that because we live in a generation where it is nothing but distractions. Instead of young men trying to find a creative outlet, instead of them trying to find a way to, you know, express their creativity, instead of them finding a way to utilize their energy, utilize their time, finding a hobby, finding a craft and mastering it, they are out here indulging all kind of foolishness. They want to party, they want to turn up, they want to go do stupidness. You see, guys, back then men did not have what we have today. You know, back then men had to work, men had to grind, men were constantly moving. They didn't have the luxury of, you know, how millennials have it today, where we could just chill in our parents' house, they're gonna take care of us, and we could do as we please. No, they had to be on their shit at a young age. They had to grow up fast, so they was constantly working. They wasn't sitting around all day wasting their creative energy. They wasn't sitting around all day, you know, spewing out their creative energy over a screen, because they had no phones back then. They were living in the moment. They were constantly creating, they were constantly building, constantly making something, because back then that's what they had to do to kill time. You see, these days, to kill time, we can pick up with our phone, our tablet, our laptop, go watch a YouTube video, go watch a movie. It's a click away, and we can do that shit right in our bed. Back then, they had to physically go out the house, go to a premiere, a theater somewhere, go, you know, where it was showing. They did not watch it at their house. So, guys, I say all that to say this. We have gotten lazy. We have no substance in anything we created these days. There's no substance in anything, from the music, from the art, from everything, from the food. There's no substance in anything because people are empty of their energy. You see, guys, us men, we are the producers. Women are consumers. We produce. We are made to create. We are the co-creators of the earth. The Most High Yahweh, He made man in His image. We are supposed to be creating, but instead we are not creating. Instead, we are wasting our energy on things that are not adding value to this world. You got rappers out here who are constantly indulging in drugs, alcohol. They're killing their minds. They're dumbing down their pineal glands. They're dumbing down their spirits so they can't grasp ideas. They can't take ideas out the air because they're so busy in a fog from all the pills and, you know, GMO stuff that is being downloaded into the system. So the products they're making, it has no substance. Not only that, we live in a fast food time. We live in a time where people don't want to put the work in and see results 10 years later, 5 years later. People want to have that shit, put it out, and then expect it to blow up, expect it to do good by tomorrow night or by next year. Guys, anything that you make, any product that you create, is going to take time. It's going to take dedication. It's going to take you being persistent in mastering that for it to be better. One of my favorite mangakas, bro, because me, I'm an artist, and I'm writing my own manga. Toriyama, bro. This dude, bro, was grinding on his shit, bro. If you know who Akira Toriyama is, he is the creator of Dragon Ball Z, Bro, I'm telling you, bro, he's one of my inspirations because when you look into his past and what he had to go through, this dude was grinding. He was grinding, bro. I'm telling you. And as a mangaka, bro, working, that shit is not easy, bro. You're drawing all day long. And I use that example because back then, men were on their purpose. They were on their grind. They was doing what they had to do to make themselves better. They were doing what they had to do to secure themselves in the long run. You know, they knew that in their youthful years is the time to put the work in their youthful years is the time where they have the energy, they have the, you know, vitality, they have the vigor to chase their, you know, goals head on and to be able to succeed and to be able to benefit themselves. Men don't have that mentality these days because mom and dad is going to take care of it. Now guys, I'm not going to sit here and act like that my parents don't take care of me or that my parents, you know, haven't given me a good lifestyle where I can say I'm privileged in that field, because they have. I mean, everything I wanted when I was younger, I got it. But as I got older, I started realizing that it's time to become a man. You know, even if you live in your parents' house still, you need to start changing your mentality. You need to start changing how you view things in this world. You know, you have to really start finding things that's going to make you want to be better, that's going to make you want to, you know, improve yourself better. Because guys, you got to listen to this one. You're only going to be in your youth one time. You're only going to be in your youth one time. So if you're chasing play, if you're chasing girls, if you're knocking up girls and all that stuff, and you waste your youthful years, you could have used those years to learn a skill, to learn a talent, and benefit, and, you know, master that talent, and, you know, and, you know, what's it called? Get better in that talent, get better in that field. But here's the thing, a lot of men don't want to do that. So what do we have these days? We have no substance because there's no creativity flowing. All the creativity that's supposed to be flowing is being wasted. It's being dumped on a girl's back. It's being dumped on her face and all that. And guys, I'm not going to sit here and say that if you don't want to, that you can't have girls. You know, if you don't want to do retention, if you don't want to go down this field, then hey, bro, to each his own. But it's just a thought that dawned on me because you go to some places sometimes and you still see how all this stuff that was created in the 1920s, how it's still around, you know, all this stuff that was created back then, how it still has an imprint on today. You know, people are constantly taking from it, even whether it's music stuff. Guys, the music these days is nothing but samples of the music from like the 60s and 70s, or is nothing but rehashes of a song that came out in the 90s or so, the early 2000s, because back then they had substance in their work. Kanye even said it himself. When Kanye first was coming up, he said, I wasn't focusing on women. I wasn't focusing on none of that. It was wake up, go to the studio, make beats, you know, practice on my rapping, all of that. Watch Kanye's old videos, bro. He was like, I was on my shit. He said, I wasn't worrying about all that. I wasn't worrying about partying. I wasn't about club. It was waking up. I'm in the studio first thing, and I'm not leaving the studio until I got a masterpiece out of there. You need to have that mentality. You need to find a hobby. You need to keep focusing on a hobby. You need to, if you're a person who makes beats, make a beat. Take 3 hours out the day, make that beat, and keep making that beat until it's perfect. Even if you finish it within 30 minutes, go back, listen to that beat 3 times, and be like, you know what, I can do something different with this beat. If you're somebody who like to customize cars or something, bro, put your energy into that mess, bro. You know, keep draw designs of cars, draw up different customs that you can do to pimp out cars and all that. So maybe one day, if you put money towards that, you can start your own customization business and customizing cars or doing designs for people, you know, or how they want their car customized. You could do it like that. If you're an artist, I'm an artist, draw, bro. Just keep drawing. Even if you draw like shit, just keep drawing, bro. I cannot draw for shit when I first started out. I used to draw little stick figures. I cannot draw for shit. I just kept on drawing. I just kept on going. I just kept on being motivated, being persistent. And the thing is, you got to be persistent. Nobody can be persistent but you. Nobody can tell you to be persistent but you. Nobody can coach you. Nobody can guide you but you. Now, guys, I don't want this video to be all over the place, but the main theme of this video, the main point of this video, there is a loss of creativity in this modern day. This modern dispensation, there is no creativity. Music is fast. Food service these days. The music that is made today, in 10 years nobody will be bumping it. In 10 years time, people are still going to be bumping music from the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, because those music has substance. People came together. People actually played the instruments. people actually wanted to make good music. They didn't just hop in the studio, throw something together, and put it out for streams to get a bag. And that's the problem. These days, everybody wants to do something to get a bag. Nobody wants to do something for passion. Nobody wants to do something just for the love of it. Nobody wants to do none of that. Everybody just wants to make something and throw it out there because they want to make a bag off of it. And the minute they make that bag, they're just going to drop it. But guys, when you do something for the love of it, when you do something for the passion, for the thrill of it, that is when that is really going to have substance. That is when that product is really going to shine. That is that whatever you're creating is really going to bring value into this world. I hope you guys took something from this video. I'm going to be out. Make sure y'all stay blessed.